Hi guys, welcome to our channel, the number one place for people who love design, art and all things creative. You are watching DMB's channel, my name is Laszlo, and today I'm going to demonstrate how you can create a convincing 3D illustration of a Barndominium style building, with the help of nothing but Adobe Illustrator and Adobe Photoshop. If you follow us, then you know that I made a very similar video recently, which was a step-by-step guide on how to create a living room interior design scene, with this bunch of new 3D tools and functions that has been added to the latest version of Adobe Illustrator 2022. And if you missed that video, maybe check that one out first. Because now, since I thought I have already shown you the beginner level steps of this isometric design style, why don't we try and push these functions to their absolute limits to see if we could create a professional looking architectural rendering with these tools. Okay, let's jump straight in. First things first, I need to put what I call the skeleton of the design in place, which is going to be a quite time-consuming process of extruding basic shapes with Illustrator's 3D panel, until we get something that is actually resembling one of those barn-style farmhouses. If you are not familiar with this architectural design style, a barndominium or barndo is exactly what it says on the tin. It's a barn that has been converted into a living space. Barndominiums have risen in popularity over the last couple years as they are quite affordable, energy efficient and low maintenance homes for people who are into that authentic farm inspired modern farmhouse design style. Once the house has been knocked into shape, I open up Illustrator's Materials tab, and one by one, add some nice wooden texture to, well, pretty much the whole of the design. There isn't a crazy amount of pre-installed materials in Illustrator's library, but the ones they do have are quite heavily customizable, so we get the chance to make the most of what we got here, really. Once I'm done with the materials, I transfer the whole thing onto Photoshop by turning the design onto a smart PNG object. Photoshop is just the better tool if you want more control over your design work, especially if you wanna go for that more hands-on, manual, intuitive rendering style. So after all those automated functions, here I'm going to hand paint in a bunch of shadows, highlights and whatnot to get the best of both worlds and see where that takes us. Okay, things are looking pretty good, so I thought the house is a bit boring on its own, so I'm going back to Adobe Illustrator to create some trees we can scatter around this barn. Here I'm mostly using the revolve function to turn these simple halved shapes onto the bases of pine trees, trunks and some, well, normal looking trees with a circular foliage as well. I drag and drop these into place in my Photoshop file, then I have to make sure that they feel native to the environment by adding some more layers of paint on top here and there, as well as knocking out a very simple background as well. So here we go, this is how the finished product looks like. And I mean, I think it looks pretty decent. given that it's not actually based on a real 3D model. But yeah, feel free to let me know what you think of this fake 3D design style. If you are a regular creative crew member, then you know that this video is kind of that perfect melting pot of our content, because we tend to talk quite a lot about illustration, graphic design, interior design, architecture, and everything else in between all these cool things. So if any of that interests you, feel free to follow along. Please leave a like to help us reach even more people with this video, and I hope to see you next time with some other cool creative stuff, okay? Until then, see you guys!